offensive language offends you, then don't watch this video. But this is video number 2 of my little Halloween countdown that I'm gonna be doing year after year from now on, just for the heck of it. So this is Splatterhouse, originally released on the Turbografx 16 console, PC Engine, Japan. He looks like Jason on steroids, but it's pretty much what it is. It's a nerdy dude. He's a parapsychologist along with his girlfriend. They visit this house. She gets kidnapped. He puts on this mask, and all of a sudden he's really strong and no longer a little skinny nerdy guy, and he has to save his girlfriend. It's pretty simple control wise. It pretty much plays like an NES game. You have a jump button and an attack button. You press up or down. You can duck or pick up weapons in the background. This is a rather difficult game. It's not for the faint of heart. So we're already on stage 2. Yeah. Watch out for the vomit puddles. Just like in real life, you don't want to slip on vomit. This is, to me, a truly great Halloween game, because it's, just look at it. These guys, hit them and jump over. Recommend grabbing this 2x4 here. I don't think you can hurt those guys, or whatever they are, I just jump over them. And we're off to boss number 2. The haunted room, as some people call it. I don't know the official name of the boss. You know this dude is tough as nails when he can punch a knife and not bleed. Crap. Not good. And I'm dead. faced it that time. And watch out for the chandelier. I know there's another one back there that has to be. Oh, try to avoid this crap right here. Ha, made it. On to stage 4. This game is freaky. Take that. I just punched a bat to death. I hate bats in video games, so I find that slightly therapeutic to punch a bat to pieces. I know I'm punching like a spaz, but trust me, you do the same thing. Let me out of here. I don't like that. Not creepy at all. Oh, and I have a machete or a cleaver. More like a cleaver. Ouch. The music to this boss fight is awesome. I don't like the fight so much, though. Ah. Okay. Well, we got him. Pretty much how I remember church, too. I'm sorry, that was unnecessary. And that's Jennifer, Rick's girlfriend. Yeah, the main character's name Rick. Forgot to tell you that. His girlfriend's name Jennifer. Now you know. You know he's half the battle. Just rename this game Panic Attack, because that's what it gives me. It's fun, but like super scary. Oh man, crap, super spooky. Stay away from me, you turd. Leave me alone, you turd. Oh, this crap again. No. No. Let's go through this again. Oh yeah, you're just waiting for me, aren't you? Kind of reminds me of high school. Everybody ganging up on you. Wow. Thanks. Remind me to just avoid that part altogether next time. Resurrect the dead. I'm gonna get you. Do your little bull crap. Yeah, you're dead now. Are you kidding me? Ridiculous. Okay, he will stab you outright. Alright, I thought maybe I could find a break in the pattern, but apparently standing in front of this jerk is not going to work. A certain distance. go to hell. Not the girl, the monster. Stage 6. I forgot about the sliding kick. I think that can do double damage. Oh yeah. Punch, punch, punch. Come on. You're gone. Admit it. Oh, are you kidding me? There's another stage? Oh, Lord. That's what I get. Jesus. Thank you. Tommy a bit. And apparently the house is burning down. Splatterhouse staff, director, some person who is very demented. Yokoyama, also demented. What a game. Kurafune. Kobayashi. So this is all Japanese developed here. Well, there's Joshua. Who knows? Original music, Chopin. Original music. I'm not even going to try to pronounce that one. Graphic designs. That one escaped me. I can't even remember this ending. I don't know, does he get his girlfriend back or not? Spanky Asukura. That's gonna be one of the best names I've heard in a long time. Spanky. Special thanks to Bolero. '88, '90 Namco Ltd. The end. So, his girlfriend is actually dead. Well, that's Splatterhouse for you. Play at your own risk. Thanks for watching.